used to always say when I was here preaching. He let me say, "I got your back, preacher." And he was a good one to have your back. Amen. Well, it's good to be in camping. Amen. Not cramp meeting, but camping. Amen. Take your Bible and turn to 1 Samuel chapter 17. Amen. We are here not to teach you nothing. Amen. You can take your thinking caps off. Amen. You can put your notepads away. Amen. No need to even take notes. If you took notes on this message, your notes would be better than mine. Amen. And what are you here to do? We're here to aggravate you, to exhort you. Amen. If you're a young man here, we're here to ruffle your feathers. Amen. Amen. This is camp meeting time.
Amen.
Amen. We are the blood-washed band. Amen. We are King James Bible believers. We believe in the old-time religion. Amen. We believe you ought to shout. Amen. Every once in a while. While you're preaching and while you're listening to preaching. We believe you ought to have sweat in your socks when you're done preaching. Amen. And we love camp meeting. Amen. And I've had a blast. I know everybody can't do it, but I know staying at the Nagowski home is a real blessing and honor for me and my wife. And to watch the servants, they've got a Phoebe spirit over there, buddy. I'll tell you what, them girls wait on us hand and foot. I mean, literally. And it's a blessing. Amen. That home's always been that way. Brother Bob, I don't know how he did it, but he did it. Amen. God's been good, I'll tell you. Amen. I'm trying to put a plug in because I've learned in evangelism a long time ago, if the pastor's wife likes you, you'll get invited back. Amen. Candy's the best cook. Amen. But thank God for it. Amen. God's people are the best. Amen. 1 Samuel 17, y'all know the story here. This is David killing Goliath. Amen. I preached on this one time. The Bible says there he shouted for the battle. I like that. I got a whole message on that. And I preached that one time up in Chicago. And a feller come to me after church. And he was troubled. And he walked up to me and says, "Brother Mcgaughey," he goes, I don't quite understand. He says, "Are you advocating violence?" I said, "Advocating violence?" I said, "Did you understand what I preached about? David killed Goliath."
Amen.
"Can you get much more violent than that?" And he threw a rock and sunk it in his head, then jumped on top of him, took his own sword, and hacked his head off. Amen. And then carried the head around with him for a while. Amen. How much more violent can you get than that? Amen. But we don't like violence. Because you're weird.
Yeah.
Amen. I mean, who wouldn't want to see a fight in Walmart if a fight broke out? Wouldn't you want to watch? Huh? I usually don't talk about this when she's here. Because, amen, I'm scared of her. But my little wife. That's what attracted me to her. Amen. I seen this little blonde-haired gal, and I wanted to go out with her and talk to her. Then I heard one day, they said, "Dee Harrison is fighting Sally Oosley after school." I went, "Huh? What?" "Oh, yeah, big fight out at Rosie's." And Rosie's was a little cafe down from the high school. So, I mean, anybody that's anybody's going to go see that. Wouldn't you? So I went down there, man, there's a bunch of people waiting. Sure enough, you've seen a little entourage coming. Here comes Sally Oosley. She's got her buddies with her. Amen, you could hear the music. Then over here on the other side, here comes Dee Harrison. She's got her little entourage. But it is happening. I mean, you could cut the electricity, cut the air, you can feel it. Can you feel it? Man, we were there, and sure enough, a squared circle just opened up. You could almost hear somebody, let's get ready to rumble. In this corner, the Spitfire McGowan, weighing in 100 none of your business. I don't even think she was 100 pounds then. Cut something real fast. But they started fighting, and sure enough, say, what happened? D beat the snot out of her. And I stood there with tears in my eyes. I said, I'm over. I got to have her. Amen. So I like that. Amen. And I love this story in the Bible. And that fella, he said, well, he said, I would like to get your address, your email. I'd like to correspond with you, but don't give me your aggression. No. You go, why not? I said, it'd make me like you. Amen. You know, there's a pacifist side of Christianity. Amen. And it don't fit in with us. Amen. There's a militant side. There's a militant edge in here that you can almost feel. Amen. And we like the battle. We like the fight. Amen. And I love this story. We're going to just pick it up here. Man, it's hard just to... We're just going to look at the end of this. Look at verse number 52. This is after, amen, the big fight. And oh, man, what a thing. And the Bible says in verse 52, and the men of Israel and Judah arose and shouted. You see that? You say, well, I ain't into shouting. Well, we ain't into you then. You bother us. Amen. People talk about dead churches. Your wife churches are dead. Because you're dead. Amen. You say, well, I just don't express myself that way. Well, you're wrong. Amen. Hallelujah. Said the men of Israel and Judah arose and shouted and pursued the Philistines until thou come to the valley and the gates of Ekron, and the wounded of the Philistines fell down by the way of Sheerim. How do you say that? Even unto Gath and unto Ekron. And the children of Israel returned from chasing after the Philistines. And they spoiled their tents. And David took the head of the Philistine and brought it to Jerusalem. You see that? Carried it around with him. I told people there's two guys there fighting for the Israelites. Since you stop mentioning the Bible, you've got to read this in between the lines. One of those guys' names was Taxi, the other one's name was Dermy. Amen. And they came up with a new system. They helped David out. Amen. So from here on out, David had this head, this with a rock sunk in it. Amen. Say how you know we got there's I got a deer head and amen. Turkey fans, largemouth bass. Amen.
Amen.
Taxidermy. Thank God for them old boys.
Amen.
Amen. In verse 55, and when Saul saw David go forth against the Philistine, he said unto Abner, the captain of the host, Abner, whose son is this youth? And Abner said, as thy soul liveth, O king, I cannot tell. And the king said, inquire thou whose son the stripling is. The stripling. And as David returned from the slaughter of the Philistine. You see that?
Yeah.
Folks, you can't slaughter somebody and make it look cosmetically nice. Huh? If it's a slaughter, it's bad. There's blood everywhere.
Yeah.
Amen. Everybody had blood on them.
Yeah.
Amen. I remember here a few years ago. Last year, year before last, I was butchering a deer out in the yard, had it hung up in a tree, and my little granddaughter come out. And she kept saying, what's Papa doing out there? And my wife goes, go see. And she walks out there, and I've got this deer, you know, I'm skinning this deer, and she walks across, and she sees that, and she stops. And she's just standing there. She's about 4 years old. Papa. What did you do? And by the time it was over with, she was helping me. She was holding one of the legs while I was She got back in the house and I heard my daughter say, "Dad, she's got blood on her shoes." I went, "Hallelujah." "My granddaughter's got blood on her shoes." "Yeah." "Amen." "So what happened?" "I slaughtered a deer." "And we all had blood on us before it's over with." "Amen." "Isn't this fun?" "Oh, we ain't even started yet." "And as David returned from the slaughter of the Philistine, Abner took him and brought him before Saul." Look at this. "With the head of the Philistine in his hand." David seemed, amen, pretty bent on having that head with him, don't you reckon? Now let me ask you this. Did it make him have a little more clout with that head in his hand? Amen. I mean, have you heard about Gath and the giants that lived there and Goliath and all that? And all of a sudden here comes a guy in town and everybody knows, amen, on his truck, he's got this head mounted. Amen. His four-wheel drive, he's got the head of this giant. Amen. Verse 58 said, "And Saul said to him, 'Whose son art thou, thou young man?' And David answered, 'I am the son of thy servant Jesse the Bethlehemite.'" Amen. Let's pray. Father, we love you. We thank you, Lord, for saving us. Thank you, God, for camp meeting. And Lord God, as we open this book, Lord, this story has been preached, Lord, studied, and Lord, men have read it, and young men have surrendered, and through this chapter of the Word of God, and Lord, here tonight, as we read it again, God, that you'll do a work, Lord, that guts that made David step out of the crowd, Lord, help us to have some of that. Lord, the people here that, God, have gotten some victories in their life, Lord, help them to go get that victory and hold it in their hand. And Lord, do a work here tonight, God, I pray. In Jesus' name, amen. Instead of developing this whole message and doing all this, I want to give Brother Henson plenty of time. And I just want to say this. The whole message is this. Here's David standing before the king with this head of this giant in his hand. And this king wants to know, whose son are you?
Amen.
Amen. Yeah. Now, I got four older brothers. There's five of us boys, no girls in our family. And I remember growing up, I remember if we did anything that stepped, you know, made us step out above the crowd or anything like that. Yeah. I remember people saying, "Hey, ain't that one of Herb's boys?"
Amen. Yeah.
Yeah. And I don't know about y'all, but knowing that somebody would associate me, amen, with my daddy.
Yeah.
Amen, that made me feel better.
Amen.
And then there's no better joy to a father than to have his son step out and do something.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. Say, "Hey, ain't that one of Brother Bob's boys?"
Yeah.
"Isn't that one of Brother Nagowski's girls?" "Yeah, sure it is." And then when you look over there and see him, he's swelled up bigger than he is now. Amen. I speak by experience.
Yeah.
Amen. But man, to say, "Hey, whose son are you?" And this is my whole message. You got some kind of victory in your life. God, hey, hasn't God done anything for you? Has God ever give you a victory? I mean, at least are you saved? Amen. Didn't you at least get that victory? Well, can't you at least hold that in your hand? God ever helped you?
Yeah,
man alive, hey, go get that head then. Hold it. Stand up tall. Amen. Got everybody now, they live in defeat. Gotta see it. Y'all preach to people nowadays. Travel around, man, in evangelism. Everybody's sitting around, look like they, amen, sitting on the tack and sucking on a lemon.
Amen.
Y'all see it from up here. Hadn't God did anything for you? Amen. I traveled all over the place. We get travel now all over the world. And I never dreamed that. Man, got saved, been in evangelism for 24 years. And y'all see the looks people Some folks, I don't know. I don't know if I had to bet on whether they were saved. I wouldn't bet any of my money. Amen. And I see too many people get saved. We've already heard it, man, this week, Sunday morning. Man, a lot of people just raised in church. Let me ask you something. Has God ever done anything for you?
Yes. Amen.
Amen. And man alive, sitting in here, the preachers, the old men that are in here, the preacher men. Thank God for them.
Amen.
That's why I love camp meeting.
Yeah.
Amen. These guys come in and they're like old gunslingers back in the old days. Amen. Here comes old Dr. Hood in.
Hey.
With a name like Hood, you gotta be bad.
Yeah.
Amen. He comes in, everybody knows Hood from the bottoms.
Yeah.
Amen. It's like an old gunslinger. Like come in with his hat down low and that grease holster. Just ready to gunfight at any moment. Come in, mule skinner.
Yeah.
Knife sharpened.
Yeah.
Amen. Come in here and see these other folks, these old men of God, Brother Heaton.
Thank God.
Can you hear me? These old men look like, he always looked like to me like John Dillinger.
Yeah. Amen.
Got a machine gun somewhere. Man, when you hear these guys preach, that's the way it is.
Yeah.
But then you get around these other circles.
Oh my.
Yeah.
And you see a little slick politician come in.
Come on.
Don't look like he's ever even been in a street fight in his life.
Amen.
Probably never been in a fight even in elementary school.
Yeah.
Huh? Been to Bible school. He's polished and prim. Huh?
Yeah.
His wife could whip him.
Amen. Glory.
And he comes in and he's polished and amen. He's got a little flower in his lapel. Huh? And he preaches, sounds like a girl.
Yeah.
Amen. I don't know about y'all, that's about as far away from Bible Christianity as you can get.
Amen.
Say, what did God do? I'll tell you what God did. God took the worst among you and called him to preach.
Yeah.
The Bible said he chose the foolish things of the world to confound the wise. Say, what do you mean? Look around in here.
Amen.
He chose the base things.
Glory.
Amen.
Amen.
Here's Kyle Joe Hicks on how much baser can you get than that? How much lower can you get than that? Amen. These guys come in you say you're bragging on them. Well, when they come in, they walk into a room, their presence does something for the building.
Amen.
Amen. You say, why is that? They've had some victories in their life.
Yes. Amen.
You can hear it when they preach.
Yes, sir.
Amen. And God done something for them.
Yes.
And it shows in their family.
Yes.
I've stayed in their homes.
Right. Right.
Amen. Sister Hood, she was a Phoebe.
Yes.
And she loved God, loved the preacher, loved the ministry.
Yes.
Loved preacher.
Yes, sir.
Loved people. Get around some of these preachers' wives now, you don't know if they love anybody. They're the most sourest people they are.
Wow.
I'm telling you, y'all travel around. We was in a meeting one time, my wife says, who is the pastor's wife? We've been there 3 days. I said, it's that woman sitting back yonder that's mad at everybody. Listen to me. Haven't God done anything for you, ma'am? Amen. You got a good husband? You got children that are here? You got people in church? Do you ever answer the prayer? God ever been good to you? Once you get that in your hand, then.
Amen.
You kids that are here, we preach hard to y'all, but man, some of y'all are our heroes. You ain't never been in a bar. You ain't never been on drugs. Thank God. Amen. Here you are in church. Just as saved as we are. And every once in a while, man, climb out on one of those victories and have a blast. Amen. We're saved by the grace of God. Rescued. Not going to hell. And then reach up and get that giant saved. soul to Christ?
Yeah, glory.
Amen. You ever fought against a booger man?
Yeah.
You ever live for God? You will.
Yes, sir.
You ever tried to crawl up next to you? Has ever tried to stop you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Yeah. The other day, we was in a church the other day, a few months ago, and man, some of these churches, you stay in the church and stuff, it's weird. There's a weird spirit in there. Ain't nobody there. The booger man hangs around in there. In this church, before, had problems. A preacher messed up. Another preacher friend of mine comes to the church. Old Brother Bemis, Nathan Bemis, said, open up Bibles, brother. Put them everywhere in there. It's a weird spirit. Here I am staying there. Middle of the night, about 2:30 in the morning, I woke up. Sit up in bed just like this. Huh? Man, the hair standing up on my arms and my back. I couldn't hardly breathe. And I'm sitting there, and all of a sudden this voice goes, who are you? I ain't nobody. But I'm saved by the one who's everybody.
Amen.
And I'm saved by Jesus' blood. I'm washed in his blood.
Amen.
Leave me alone. Get out of here. Amen. What is that? That's a booger man. Amen. The spirit left out of there. He said, I don't believe that. Well, it ain't for unbelievers.
Yeah.
I'm not there. I know it happened. Hey, got any victories in your life?
Amen.
You said, well, you don't know how bad I've messed up. Well, let me ask you this. How good have you ever messed up? How good have you ever messed down? Amen. Messed in. I don't know. Has God ever done anything? Amen. I mean, I'm at all of us. You want to keep score, do you? God ain't God been good to you?
Yeah.
This is Camp Meeting. I mean, at least acknowledge that. At least give God credit for what he's done good in your life. What, you going to give the devil all the credit?
No.
That's good.
David stepped out. I need a stripling. Do I have a volunteer? No, I ain't got no volunteer. Come on, stripling. Come on. This ain't a debate. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Stripling, a formidable foe weighing in at all of 40 pounds. Here he is, David. Amen. You say, well, I don't believe he was that small. He was small enough where the king called him a stripling.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
And here's David. Y'all know the story. How David does. He comes up there to the battle. And the Bible said that he shouted for the battle. Amen. Can I get a witness? Is there any other believers here? Have you ever read that story? Have you ever read about him getting 5 smooth stones? Amen. Said, why did he get 5? I've heard the theologians. I've heard them say that 5's a number of death. I'm telling you that Goliath had brothers. Amen. They had a full clip. Stripling. So what he does, he goes out in the brook and gets him 5 smooth stones. I ain't gonna make you do all that. But those smooth stones are always in the rough water.
Amen.
Don't you reckon that when he was in that brook gathering them stones in that rough water and gathering 5 smooth ones, that he never felt more alone in his life?
Right.
Don't you reckon the devil come and said, what are you doing? Have you seen God? But he gets 5 smooth stones. Here he is standing. Hold your sling. Got it? On your belt there, son. There's a bag in your belt. And you have put 5 smooth stones. Count them. Not 1, not 2, not 3, not 4, 5. Amen. And you got 5 smooth stones. And here stands over here Goliath.
Yeah.
Here's Goliath. Say, in this corner, Goliath, weighing in at 300 and none of your business. Yeah. Here's Goliath standing there, and Goliath sees Stripling.
Yeah.
And the Bible said he laughed. What? You sent me a dog out here? What? I'll feed his flesh to the fowls of the earth. Do you know what Stripling does? The Bible said that he ran across the field. So here's the giant. Now get your sling, son, and run and sling that stone. You ready? On your mark, you're ready. You're the Stripling. Down goes Goliath. Now what he does next is he gets a sword. I hate to do all this stuff. He gets a sword. Can I borrow this man? Amen. So now what you do is you run over and you hack his head off, okay? Here's the picture I want you to see. This is what I want you to see. Hold on, this is going to take some time. This is what I want you to see. Come over here, sir. Here's the picture I want you to see. Right. Set that down. Let's see if we can do this. Victories right here in this meeting.
Amen.
Amen. What are you going to let the devil do? Defeat you on the one time you messed up? You let him, he'll do it.
Yes, he will.
Whose son are you? Amen. Father, we love you.